My name is Lakshmi Narayana, PGT Botany, Model School, Atmakur, Surabaya district. Yes, here our lesson is animal tissues. In this lesson, learning outcomes are conceptual understanding. The students will find out the similarities and differences among the epithelial and connective tissues. Students will cite examples for various types of connective tissues. And second one is asking questions and making hypotheses. The students will form a hypothesis to know what would happen to the human if there are no platelets in blood. And next one here, experimentation and field investigation. The students will prepare a thin slide of blood, observe it and submit a report on it. And fourth one is the information skills and projects. The students will collect the information from the internet regarding blood donation procedure. Fifth one, communication through drawing and model making. Students will draw the diagram of areolar tissue or adipose tissue or bone, any other, etc. Appreciation and aesthetic sense values. The students will appreciate the role of white blood cells as policemen and scavengers in the blood, in the body. Application to daily life, concern to diversity. This is the seventh one. The students will observe the method how muscles are attached to bones in our body. Yes, I will ask one of the question. What is the structural and functional unit of our body? What is the structural and functional unit of our body? Yes, right. Cell is the structural and functional unit of our body. Who discovered the cell? Right answer. Robert Hooke discovered the cell. Who proposed the cell theory? Yes, right answer. Sneeden and Sean scientists proposed the cell theory. Can you say what are the main features of cell theory? Yeah. All organisms are made up of cells. Cell is the functional unit of each and every action. Cell is the functional unit of our body. It means each and every function is related to cell. For example, your respiration. How respiration takes place? What are the cell organelles are helpful in the respiration? Mitochondria. Yes. In the same manner, protein synthesis. Ribosome cell organelles are helpful in the protein synthesis. One more question. In plants, how many types of tissues are there? In plants, how many types of tissues are there? Right answer. Four types of tissues are there. Four types. First one is the dermal tissue. And second one is the meristematic tissue. And third one is the ground tissue. And fourth one is the vascular tissue. Dermal tissue, meristematic tissue, ground tissue and vascular tissue. Okay, what is the function of the dermal tissue? What is the function of the dermal tissue? Yes, it is helpful to give protection to the inner tissues. And next one, what is the importance of meristematic tissue? We know that meristematic cells every time divide and redivide, it will produce new cells. It is helpful for the growth of the plants. Next here, another one is the ground tissue. We know that ground tissue contains parenchyma, colenchyma, stearenchyma. Parenchyma can store the food material, whereas this one colenchyma and the stearenchyma tissues are helpful to give mechanical strength to the plant body. Yes. Next one is the vascular tissue. Vascular tissue contains xylem and phloem. Xylem is helpful for the conduction of water and minerals. And the phloem is helpful for the conduction of food materials. Okay. Yes, here sometimes one of the doubt arises in our mind, what is a tissue? What is a tissue? Can anyone say what is a tissue? Exactly. Tissue is a group of cells. Tissue is a group of cells with similar structure and function. Okay, up to now we discussed about the plant tissues. Now today we are going to discuss about animal tissues. Today we are going to discuss about animal tissues. In the same manner how plants contain different tissues, animals also contain majorly four types of tissues. There, first one is the epithelial tissue, and second one is the connective tissue, third one is the muscular tissue, fourth one nervous tissue. Yes, animals contain majorly four types of tissues: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue. Like this, majorly four types of tissues are present in animals. And here, I would like to conduct one of the lab activity. Okay, for the lab activity purpose, we require a small piece of chicken. Small piece of chicken we require, and next microscope, dilute HCl. We have to place a little bit of chicken piece inside the dilute HCl for 2 hours. Later we have to take a small bit of chicken piece, this one skin is the epithelial tissue. And we have to take this one and place on the another slide a little bit is enough. Then press the slide with another slide. Then gently remove the slide. Cover the slide with a cover slip.
and press gently. Place the cover slip on the slide. If we can place the slide here, then we observe the slide, it will appear like this. Yeah, when we observe the epithelial tissue under microscope, it will appear like this. This is the epithelial tissue. Here, cells are arranged very closely with each other, and cells are maybe polygonal in shape. Polygonal shape. In between these two cells, there is no intercellular space. Cells are without intercellular space. And the function of the epithelial tissue is to give protection. We know that epithelial tissues are also divided into three types, like squamous epithelial tissue, cuboidal epithelial tissue, and columnar epithelial tissue. Squamous epithelial tissue, cuboidal epithelial tissue, and another one is the columnar epithelial tissue. In the previous class, we learned about these types of epithelial tissues. Squamous epithelial tissue. Those cells are polygonal in shape and very flat in nature. Intercellular spaces are absent and it is helpful to give protection. And squamous epithelial cells are majorly helpful in filtration process. And the squamous epithelial cells are semi-permeable in nature. Semi-permeable in nature. You know about the semi-permeability. Semi-permeability means it allows only some types of tissue, some types of substances inside the cells or tissues. Not all the substances into the body, only some type of selectively substances only enter into the body. The other substances, other microorganisms, other harmful substances, they can't enter into the body. That thing is done by squamous epithelial tissue. Here, example for the squamous epithelial tissues, you know, lining of mouth, lining of esophagus. Inside the mouth and the esophagus and the alveoli. What are alveoli? In the lungs, minute sac-like structures are present. Those minute sac-like structures are the sac, means bag-like structures, small. Those are the alveoli. Those alveoli also contain squamous epithelium tissue. And next one is the cuboidal epithelium tissue. Those cuboidal epithelial cells are cube-like in manner, and those are helpful here to give protection. They are helpful to give protection. Here, tubules of kidneys are example for the cuboidal epithelial tissue. And next one is the columnar epithelial tissue. Columnar epithelial tissue. Okay, the columnar epithelial tissues are pillar-like manner. They are helpful in different functions like filtration, different functions as secretions. Secretion functions, these columnar epithelial cells are helpful. Okay, this is about the epithelial tissue. Next, the connective tissue is there, muscular tissue is there, and nervous tissue is there. Okay, just now we observed that one of the lab activity about the epithelial tissue. In the same manner, we can observe the second one, this one, third one is there, no? Muscular tissue. Muscular tissue we can observe in the microscope also. Yes, every time whenever you can observe the lab activity, at the time we have to write one of the lab activity in your notebooks. You know the some of the main important points in the lab activity. We have to write the aim and next apparatus, then procedure, and finally result we have to mention in the lab activity notebook. Yes, if we can write one of the another lab activity about what is this one, muscular tissue. Muscular tissue lab activity. This is the muscle one. This one is the muscle. We have to place the muscle tissue in the dilute HCl in 2 hours. In the next day, we have to take a small bit of muscle tissue. Here, we have to take a small bit of muscle tissue and place this muscle tissue on the slide. You have to take this one on the slide. This will be on the slide. And place it another slide on the muscle. A little bit is enough. A little bit muscle tissue is enough for our observation. Okay, then muscle tissue have to cover with one of the cover slip. Then gently press it and apply it on the microscope. Observe the slide under the microscope. When we observe under the microscope, the muscle tissue will appear like this. This is the muscle tissue. If we know about the muscle tissues, striated muscles, non-striated muscles, and cardiac muscles. Okay, let's come our topic, connective tissue. Yes, this is the connective tissue. Okay, before this one, just we will observe the chicken piece. Where all these tissues are present. When we observe this one,
the outermost layer, this is the epithelial tissue. And next one, below the epithelial, fat storing tissue is there. Fat storing adipose tissue is there. This adipose tissue is the connective tissue. And another one, this one is the inner one, is the muscle tissue. And here fine thread-like white structures are present in the body. These fine thread-like structures, this is the nervous tissue. Yes, epithelial tissue and connective tissue, fat storing adipose tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue and nervous tissue. Four types of tissues are there. And again your connective tissue. First of all, what is the connective tissue? The internal organs located at specific places because there is no displacement in organs due to a special tissue, that is connective tissue. We know heart is situated towards the left side of the chest region. It do not move any other side. Whenever we tilt our body, our heart does not move. It is situated at particular place. And the kidneys are situated here either side of the backbone, above the hips region. They do not move at any side. They are situated at a particular position due to a special type of tissue. A special tissue is the connective tissue that can connect the organs, that can place the organs and tissues in a particular place. Yes, here in the connective tissue also some of the types are there. Adipose tissue is there, areolar tissue is there, and bone is there, cartilage, ligament, and the blood also there. Areolar tissue. Okay, areolar tissue means here where the epithelial tissue connects to the muscle tissue. Epithelial tissue, skin connects to the muscle tissue. In that region, a tissue is there, that is the areolar tissue. This areolar tissue is mainly helpful in packing. Okay, packing the tissues, packing the organs. This areolar tissue is helpful. Areolar tissue. Okay, areolar tissue is present below the skin, below the epithelial tissue. It attaches the skin and muscle tissues. And another connective tissue is the adipose tissue. Below the skin only fat storing tissue is there. That fat storing tissue below the skin fat storing tissue is known as the adipose tissue. First one is the areolar tissue and another one is the adipose tissue, and next one is the bone. We know about the bone. This is the bone tissue, and another one is the cartilage. Okay, tip of the bones, one of the connective tissue is there, that is known as the cartilage. And next, ligament. Ligament, another tissue. Tendon is also there. And final connective tissue is the blood. Areolar tissue, adipose tissue, bone, cartilage, ligament, tendon, blood. All these are seven types of connective tissues are there. Okay, just now we discussed that
connective tissue means a special tissue which is helpful to place the organs and tissues in a particular place. In the connection of connecting of tissues and organs, that is the connective tissues. Internal organs located at specific places because there is no displacement in organs due to a special tissue, that is connective tissues. When we observe the functions of connective tissues, just now we discussed that alveolar tissue, adipose tissue, and the bone, ligament, tendon. Those tissues perform special functions like they help in binding the other tissues, binding the other tissues and organs together. They provide a framework and support to various organs in the body. Bone connective tissue that gives support to the body. They are providing a framework and supporting to various organs in the body. And blood is another connective tissue. What is the function of that blood? Blood transport of materials from one tissue to another. And your alveolar tissue or bones or blood. In the blood, WBC are there, white blood cells are there. They give us protection. They kill the microorganisms like bacteria, viruses, and fungi. They help in protection. And some other functions are also useful in body repair. Which one helpful in body repair? Alveolar tissue. This alveolar tissue is helpful in body repair. And another tissue, connective tissue, is the adipose tissue. The adipose tissue is useful storage of fat. Okay, these are the functions of connective tissue. Help in binding the other tissues and give support to various organs, transport of materials, help in protection, and useful in body repair, storage of fats. Yes, here types of connective tissues: alveolar tissue, adipose tissue, bone, cartilage, ligament, tendon, blood. How many total? How many types are there? Seven types are there. Seven types of connective tissues. Yes, your alveolar tissue. When we see the structure of alveolar tissue, in this one we are observing that some special cells are present. Those special cells are the fibroblasts. Okay, some special cells are there in this one. Those are the fibroblasts. Along with fibroblasts, your fibers are there. Yellow elastic fibers, white fibers, and some other cells like phagocytes are also present. Mast cells also we are observing. Yes, your fibroblasts are secreting some special fibers. Special fibers. Fibrous material these are secreting. Those fibrous materials are helpful here for packing of the tissues. Here where alveolar tissue is present? Below the skin region. Alveolar tissue is present. Your alveolar tissue cells are arranged very loosely. Intercellular spaces are present. It is helpful to package of other tissues. We know that how we can take care of one glass material package. Okay, in the same manner here, alveolar tissue also helpful in package of different types of organs. Yes, we are discussing about the connective tissues.
connective tissues. Yes, these are areolar tissue, adipose tissue, bone, cartilage, ligament, tendon, blood. Yes, areolar tissue, it contains special types of cells called fibroblasts. Special types of cells, fibroblasts. These cells secrete fibrous material. These cells also help in repair of the tissues when they are injured, and these are also helpful in packing the other tissues. Package of other tissues, areolar tissue is helpful. And second one is the adipose tissue. Where it is present? Below the skin region. Adipose tissue is present below the skin region. It is fat storage tissue. Adipose tissue. It acts as insulator. Adipose tissue acts as insulator. Yes, the older people shiver in winter. When compared to youngsters. Why? Here, adipose tissue is present in the youngsters. That acts like as insulator. Whereas in the older people, less amount of adipose tissue is there, or absence of adipose tissue, the older people shiver. If in case adipose tissue is there, that adipose tissue controls our body temperature. It can maintain our body temperature. Our heat should not go outside the body. Otherwise, outside and coolness does not enter into our body due to adipose tissue. After adipose tissue, another one is the bone. Bone gives definite shape to body of vertebrates. Can you imagine without bone how the organisms are present? We will get a definite shape without bone? No, it is not possible. Bones are giving a definite shape to organisms, especially of vertebrates. Without bone, there is no shape to any organism. Bones are majorly contain two substances like calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate. Yes, what are the substances present in the bone? Calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate. When we see the structure of this bone here, the cells inside the bone are called osteocytes. Osteocytes are the cells of bones. This total structure is called as osteon. One central region canal is there, Haversian canal. And your pancreatic-like structures are present, canaliculi. Yes, this is about bone. And next one is the cartilage. It is present tips of ribs, external ear, etc. In those regions, cartilage is present. Tips of ribs, external ear, and joints of bones. Total shark fissure. Shark fish, total entire body is made up of cartilage. And next connective tissue is the ligament. It connects bone to bone. The connective tissue which joins bone to bone is known as ligament. Another connective tissue is tendon. The tendon connective tissue connects bone to muscle. Tendon connect bone to muscle. And finally, another connective tissue is the blood. It is also one type of connective tissue. Which one? Blood. Blood is also one type of connective tissue. Why it is called as a connective tissue? Because blood flows. The sixth one is the tendon and seventh connective tissue is blood. Blood is called as connective tissue. Why it is called as a connective tissue? It can connect other tissues. Blood flows the entire body. That's why it is called as connective tissue. It transports oxygen, carbon dioxide and nutrients to all the parts of body. It contains different types of cells like RBC.